Moral short stories. The hungry fox WHO got caught in the tree trunk. Once upon a time, there was a hungry fox that was looking for something to eat. He was very hungry. No matter how hard he tried, the fox could not find food. Finally, he went to the edge of the forest and searched there for food. Suddenly, he caught sight of a big tree with a hole in it. Inside the hole was a package. The hungry fox immediately thought that there might be food in it and became very happy. He jumped into the hole. When he opened the package, he saw slices of bread, meat and fruit in it. An old woodcutter had placed the food in the tree trunk before he began to cut down trees in the forest. He was going to eat it for his lunch. The fox happily began to eat. After he finished eating, he felt thirsty and decided to leave the hole and drink some water from a nearby spring. However, no matter how hard he tried, he could not get out of the hole. Do you know why? Yes, the fox had eaten so much food that he became too big to fit through the hole. The fox was very sad and upset. He told himself, "I wish I had thought a little before jumping into the hole." Moral: if you are too greedy, you can get trapped as well. The fox and the goat. One day, a fox fell into a well. He tried his level best to get out, but in vain. At that time, a thirsty goat passed by the well, peeped into the well and saw the fox inside. The goat asked, "What are you doing there, Mr. Fox?" "The water in this well is the finest in the whole country. Jump in and try it," said the sly fox. Not even thinking for a second, the goat jumped into the well, quenched her thirst and looked around. Just like the fox, she found herself helpless to come out. The fox said, "I have an idea. You stand on your hind legs. I can climb onto your back and then to your head and manage to pop out of the well from there. Then I shall help you come out also." The goat, once again without thinking twice, did as the fox said. The fox climbed onto the back of the goat and jumped out of the well and walked away. While walking away, the fox said, "If you had as much sense as your beard, you would have been more cautious about jumping in without making sure that you could get out again." Moral: look before you leap. Two travelers and a bear. Two men were traveling in company through a forest when, all at once, a huge bear crashed out of the brush near them. One of the men, thinking of his own safety, climbed a tree. The other, unable to fight the savage beast alone, threw himself on the ground and lay still, as if he were dead. He had heard that a bear will not touch a dead body. It must have been true, for the bear snuffed at the man's head a while, and then, seeming to be satisfied that he was dead, walked away. The man in the tree climbed down. "It looked just as if that bear whispered in your ear," he said. "What did he tell you?" "He said," answered the other, "that it was not at all wise to keep company with a fellow who would desert his friend in a moment of danger." Moral: misfortune is the test of true friendship. The dog and his shadow. Once a dog stole a piece of bone from the market. He was very happy. He was going along the side of a stream and came to the bridge. He wanted to cross the bridge. While going over the bridge, he saw that another dog was crossing the bridge with a piece of bone in its mouth. All on a sudden, a thought came across his mind. He said to himself, "If I snatch away that piece of bone, I shall have the two pieces of bone." But he did not think for once about his shadow. His shadow reflected on the water. He saw the reflection of his own shadow is the translucent, clear water of the stream. Anyway, he thought another dog would leave without delay. He ran to another dog quickly. Thus led by temptation, he forgot about the piece of bone of his mouth. When he gapped his mouth to snatch away that false piece of bone, the piece of bone in his mouth dropped into the water. It was carried away by the current stream of water. He saw that the piece of bone of another dog also dropped into the water as like as him. Then he realized that it was his own shadow. He said to himself, "Alas! Have lost my piece of bone. If I did not run after the dog, it would not happen. Now, nothing can be done." Having lost his own piece of bone, the dog went away disappointed. Moral: do not be greedy. The sick lion and the fox. One day an old lion realized that he was too old to hunt for food. The lion was sure he would soon die. He was very sad and went home. As he walked slowly home, the lion told a bird about his sad situation. "Yuation." Soon everyone in the forest heard about the lion's situation. The other animals all felt sorry for the lion. So one by one they came to visit the lion. The lion was old, weak, but very wise. As each animal came into his home, they were easy to catch and eat. Soon the old lion became happy and fat. One day, early in the morning, the fox came. The fox was very wise too. He slowly came close to the lion's home. Standing outside, he asked if the lion was feeling better. "Hello, my best friend," said the lion. "Is it you? I can't see you very well. You are so far away. Come closer, please, and tell me some kind words because I am old and will die soon." While the lion was talking, the fox was looking closely at the ground in front of the lion's house. Finally, the fox looked up and said to the lion, "I am sorry, but I must go. I am very nervous because I see the footsteps of many animals going into your home, but I see none coming out again." Moral: he is wise who is warned by the mistakes of others.